Good morning students. Today class we are going to complete the concepts of this chapter by solving the problems. So the first question is, this is the first question I am going to discuss here. The first question is what? See, a batsman deflects a ball by an angle of 45 degrees without changing its initial speed, which is equal to 54 km per hour. What is the impulse imparted to the ball? So will I read the question again? What is that? A batsman deflects a ball by an angle of 45 degrees without changing its initial speed, which is equals to what? 54 km per hour. What is the impulse imparted to the ball? So let us take that this is the surface of bat and a ball is striking the surface with an initial speed u and mass of the ball is m. He deflects the ball. They clear, they said that he deflects the ball by an angle of 45. So this is what? 45 degrees. This is the point of contact. Now, as we know very well, impulse is equal to what? Impulse is equal to what, ma? Change in momentum. So, impulse equals to change in momentum. That is initial momentum minus final momentum. So here, if you take divide these two angles into two point, what happens? 22.5 degrees and 22.5 degrees. What is the initial momentum? Is equals to mu cos theta. Yes. What about the final momentum? Final momentum also same, but its direction is opposite. So written as minus mu cos theta. Impulse I is equals to p1 minus p2 or p2 minus p1. Mu cos theta minus of minus mu cos theta. We got 2 mu cos theta. So 2 into mass of the ball is 0.15, but speed we should convert into kilometer per hour. So what is the initial speed? It is 54, 5 by 18, 18 ones are 18 threes are. So what you got? 15 meter per second. So 0.5 into what? 15 cos 22.5. On substituting all the values, we got the answer as the impulse imparted to the ball is 4.16 kg meter per second. Okay? Right. Next one is very important problem. Just see here. There is a stone of mass 0.25 kg. Tied to the end of a string is whirled in a circle of radius 1.5 meters with a speed of 40 revolutions per minute in a horizontal plane. What is the tension in the string? What is the maximum speed with which the stone can be whirled around if the string is withstand a maximum tension of what? 200 newtons. See, there is a stone of mass 0.25 kg tied to the end of a string is whirled in a circle of radius 1.5 meters with a speed of 40 revolutions per minute. So we can take this as a question, as a reference, right? Let us solve the problem. So what is the mass of the stone? Mass of the stone is how much? 0.25 kg, and it is making a frequency rotations, means what? 40 revolutions per minute. We should convert into seconds. So 40 by 60 revolutions per second So 2 2s are, 2 3s are. Frequency is equals to what? 2 by 3 revolutions per second. Now, it is rotating in a radius of 1.5 meter. Omega is equals to what? 2 pi f. 2 pi into 2 by 3, that equals to 4 pi by 3 radians per second. And next, now for example, it is making a stone is fixed here of mass m. It is making rotations, right? What is the tension the string is equals to? Centripetal force. Tension the string is equals to m v square by r, but we have r omega, so v is equals to r omega. Substitute here, what do you get? M r square omega square by r. R are cancelled. Tension is equals to what? M r omega square. M is mass, how much? 0.25 kg. Radius is 1.5 into 4 pi by 3 whole square. So the tension in the string is what? 6.58 newtons. Now what the question? If v is the maximum speed, or v max is the maximum speed we are rotating, then what is the tension it should withstand? Is 200 newtons. So we should calculate what? Maximum speed. What the formula again? T is equals to mv maximum square by r. From this, v maximum square is equals to t into r by m, or v maximum is equals to root of t into r by m. What is the tension in the string? 200. Radius is 1.5. Mass is 0.24. So 34.64 meter per second. If it is rotated with this speed, it will meet equilibrium. If the speed is more than 34.64 mega speed, what happens? If we are rotating greater than, sorry, not greater than v maximum, the string breaks and moves away from the center. Why? Because the centrifugal force will acts come into existence, breaks and moves away from the center. Okay, so this is the tension and centrifugal force problem. Next one. An aircraft executes a horizontal loop at a speed of 720 km per hour with its wing banked at 15 degrees. What is the radius of the loop? So we should calculate what? Radius of the loop. Given things what? Given speed of the aircraft, V is equals to what? 720 into 5 by 18, right? Meter per second. 18 ones are, 18 fours are, 0 remains same. 14 to 5, 200 meter per second. Banking angle, how much? 15 degrees. Right, we already derived the expression for velocity, right? What is that? V square is equals to rg tan theta. Now with this wing banked, what is the radius of the loop? We required to calculate what? R. So r is equals to v square by g tan theta. What is v? 200 whole square by g. They are not represented 10, so we should consider 9.8 into tan 15. So we get 15,232 meters. So the radius of the loop is what? 15.232 kilometers. So this is the radius of the aircraft it should rotate in this circle to be in equilibrium. Okay, right. Next question also on the same basis, let's see what that question. What is the question, ma? A train runs along an unbanked circular bend of radius 30 meters at a speed of 54 km per hour. The mass of the train is 10^6 kg. What is the angle of banking required to prevent wearing out of the rail? So to prevent wearing out of the rail, it should be banked. So they are asking directly tan theta. So same problem, right? What are the things given? There we calculated radius. Here we should calculate what? Tan theta. Let's see. Same. What are the things given? Velocity is equal to what? 54 km per hour. So we should convert again. Meter per second. 18 ones are, 18 threes are. So how much you get? 15 meter per second. Mass of the train. Mass is not needed. How much mass also remains same? Mass is cancelled, right? 10^6 kg. Next, radius is 30 meters. So maximum speed that can move on a circular path without slipping to avoid centripetal force is what? V square is equal to Rg tan theta. We require tan theta. Tan theta is equal to V square by Rg. What is V here? 15 square by R is 30 into 9.8. So you get the value 0.7653. So we should calculate which value is equal to 0.653. We should take from logarithm book. Theta is equal to tan inverse of 0.7653. That is equal to 37.4 degrees. So the banking angle between the outer edge and inner edge is what? 37.4 degrees for this train moving on a unbanked road. And the next last question. A disc revolves with a speed of 33 × 1/3 revolutions per minute and has a radius of 15 centimeters. Two coins are placed 4 centimeters and 14 centimeters away from center of the record. If the coefficient of friction between the coins and the record is 0.15, which of the coin will revolve with the record? Right. So there is a disc is revolving with some revolution having the radius 15 centimeters. Now what we done? We placed two coins 4 centimeters and put away from the center of the record. Means for example, here one coin I placed that and another coin is placed here. This is 4 centimeters and this is 14 centimeters. This disc is making rotations. So when you place a coins on a disc which is rotating, which coin will be rotating along the disc and which coin is going to fall? So what is the condition? Is the coin can revolve with the record when the force of friction is enough to provide centripetal force. If the friction is not enough, the coin slip off the record. So the coin can revolve with the record when the force of friction is enough to provide centripetal force, right? When the force of friction is enough to provide centripetal force. If force of friction is greater than centripetal force, then what happens? The coil will fall, right? So force of friction force is what? Fs should be greater than or equal to centripetal force. what is this, mu into mg should be greater than equals to what? Here it won't come, m r omega square. M condition cancel, mu g is greater than or equals to r omega square. If this condition is satisfied, then the coin remains same at the position. We will move with the coin record. If it is not satisfied, then it will move, slip off. Let's see. For disc, first, what the given frequency? F is equals to 33 into 1 by 3 revolutions per minute. Mixed fraction, 33 into 3, 99 plus 1. So, 100 by 3 revolutions per minute. We should again convert into seconds, right? 100 by 3 into 60 revolutions per second. Now, angle of frequency. Because to calculate omega, na, omega is equals to 2 pi f, 2 pi into 100 by 3 into 60. So, you got the answer as 3.49 radian per second. First coin. For first coin, let's see what is the radius where we place ma. For first coin, radius is equals to 4 centimeters. What is the formula here? Friction. What is the friction of the surface? They given that 0.15 into g, 9.8 is greater than equals to 4 into 10 raised to minus 2 into omega square, 3.49 whole square. So what is this value? Let's see, mu into g, right, is equals to 1.47, and this is r omega square value is 0.49. So it is proved that mu g is greater than r omega square. What happens? The coin will not slip off and will revolve with the record. First coin. So the coin will not slip and move to the record or disc. For second coin, all are same, but the placement of the coin is different, right? What is the placement of the coin? 14 centimeters. So already mu g is what? What is that? Mu g is equals to 1.47. R omega square is what? 14 into 10 raised to minus 2 into 3.49 whole square. You get 17.05. So mu g is less than r omega square, the coin will slip off. So what we learn from this point here? If the coin has to move along with the record, means one condition is satisfied, the centripetal force should be provided back with force of friction. If mu g is greater than or equals to r omega square, the coin will move along with the record because this force is more than centripetal force. If it is not, what happens? The coin will move away. So this is the way to calculate the, to apply the formulas for centripetal force and centrifugal force. Understood, students? So with this, the chapter has been completed. Thank you.